Hey, I'm Del Shanzi, and I'm here with Super Jordan, the world record-setting youngest pilot. He's been flying since he was 10 years old. Youngest pilot on the planet, and he took the record from a 14-year-old girl who happens to be his sister, Savannah. So Savannah, his sister, used to be the youngest pilot in the world at age 14. We are here going through the 304 reasons the flat top paramotor is the only paramotor to buy or fly. There are huge safety issues. You're talking 19 people dead in one single year on units like that, compared to nobody's ever died in the history of the sport on a flat top. Doesn't mean you can't die, it's impossible to die. It's just about the odds and stacking all the odds in your favor instead of stacking all the odds against yourself. Literally, all the other units on the market have never been updated for any of the major safety issues. Not a single one of them. The flat top addresses every single one of them. And we're going through 304 reasons. This is page 8. Okay. DOT approved gas tank for safety. So the flat top gas tank, we didn't just have some plastic maker slap together a gas tank and call it a gas tank. It's a DOT approved gas tank for kart racing, actually, which is nice. I mean, it's not a huge deal, but it is nice to know that you have a DOT approved tank as opposed to just some cheap plastic tank that could crack or have other issues. Gas tank mounted on the bottom for low center of gravity. This is a really big one for many, many reasons. One, you want as much weight as possible as far from the center of the prop as you can get it. So one of the reasons the flat top has the least amount of torque steer is because the gas tank is as far from the center of prop as possible. And if you lean to the left, notice the gas tank goes up to the right. So all the weight of that gas tank is trying to automatically make the unit stable. Where if you have the gas tank above the engine, for one, it's really close to the center of the prop, so it hardly does anything to, you know, reduce the torque steer or the felt torque steer. So it's not countering the torque steer nearly as much as if you have the tank farther away. Plus, if you lean to the right, notice your gas tank falls to the right, making the unit inherently unstable. Big issue. So very important to have your gas tank on the bottom. Also, if you trip and fall and you're running as fast as you can go, what happens if you have all that weight right up on the back of your head up high? You're gonna face plant and the unit's gonna smash you face first into the ground. Then, of course, it doesn't have face plant protection. There are no bars sticking out in front to catch that weight. Like the flat top, even if you fall down, it catches all the weight so it does not smash you face first into the ground. But generally, with that very low center of gravity, if you lose your balance, you tend to just sit down and slide safely to a stop on the skids. You ever use the skids, Jordan?
Yeah.
And slide to a stop? Yeah. So have I. We've all used it. It's just the way it goes. If you come in on a hot landing and you lose your balance, you just kind of tend to slide into a perfect stop with a flat top. Total non-issue. Have you ever had it land on your face?
No.
Never. Now, I have had other units, non-flat tops, smash me face first into the ground. Maybe that explains it. But it's a major issue. Like I had a Fly Gold 130 unit, and that harness bangs you in the back of your knees when you're trying to run. So by the time I got going as fast as I could go, and the knees, you know, it's banging me in the knees, I tripped and fell. The whole unit is so top heavy, smashed me face first into the ground, the prop hit the cage and the ground right in front of my head, and the whole thing catastrophically self-destructed. So that's kind of a bad plan. So on the flat top, we make a very low center of gravity. The weight of that fuel is as far from the prop as possible. Makes a big difference. So you didn't have to experience getting smashed face first and having a paramotor blow up on top. Have you ever had a paramotor catastrophically self-destruct?
No.
No. And that's because he flies flat tops. There's no way I'm going to put my children on units like that, where they have issues that have never been fixed. The same old issues, like the musician who is just doing a forward launch and the cage flexed into the propeller. The prop hit the back of his hand just doing a forward launch. Here, hold this, I'm gonna show you. So this thing is about as flexible as a hula hoop. Look at that. It's just like a bow. It's a bow flex. Maybe you could use it for a bow flex, but you don't want a bow flex for a paramotor. It's so flimsy that when the guy's doing a forward launch and your hand is right up against that cage, and he got hit with a little bit of gust, the cage flexed backwards, the prop hit the back of his hand, and they're still selling units all over the place that have that exact same issue. Over 100 people shredded in props, and the flat top is the only unit designed to prevent it. You can literally hang your whole body weight on the cage. Actually, we'll show you, fine, just for fun. So even if the unit falls down and you stand on the prop or stand on the engine, notice the prop does not hit the ground. I'm probably off camera. Anyway, so flat top is very tough and durable, and that is very important. So, oh yeah, we were talking about the gas tank mounted at the bottom. Yeah, it's very low center of gravity. We got a little off subject there. We will get to that. That's still in there. Gas tank mounted very low for counter-reducing torque steer. So that's another reason when you see like a 10-year-old Super Jordan take off, you don't see him getting torqued all the way to the side. Or you have lighter kids or women, you need to be able to deal with the torque properly. And with the flat top, with the weight shift kit, you have the best weight shift in the world. And because of how it's set up, you don't have as much torque as you do with other units, and you can completely eliminate it very easily by just weight shifting. Okay, gas tank mounted forward below frame for optimal prop clearance. Here's another issue you would, it's just one of these things you'd never think of when you're new getting into the sport. But notice how the gas tank on a flat top is under the frame. The frame comes down and it's in the middle of the gas tank. If the gas tank was behind the frame, that gas tank would be very close to your prop. And that's how it is on almost all other units. When their gas tank is mounted clear behind the frame, you trip and fall down like on a Blackhawk, boom, the prop can go right through the gas tank. That's kind of not an issue I wanted to have. So I moved the gas tank forward as far as we could get it, where your legs will still, it's impossible for your legs to touch it if your harness is adjusted properly. But it also brings that center of gravity forwards because you're pulling that gas tank and the weight under the frame instead of behind the frame. So like the Fresh Breeze, the weight of that gas tank is completely behind the frame, sticking that weight farther back away from you. So, okie dokie, that is another one where it is at. Mounted under for prop clearance. So yes, it's much farther back. Also the flat top uses big mounting plates for the engines, which a lot of other units do not use. So like a Scout, if you look at the motor mounts, they're only 6 inches apart. So the whole engine on a Scout can wobble up and down. So not only is their gas tank completely behind the frame, closer to the prop, but because their engine can wiggle up and down, if you so much as bump it, the prop can go right through the cage, because the prop will swing way forward. Where the flat top, the engine is mounted to a plate, a solid plate, and the plate has the mounting, the rubber motor mounts. So you have your motor mounts over twice as far apart, so you have very little flex up and down on that engine. So lots of little things that combine to make the flat top absolutely the safest and best unit on the market with that tightest center of gravity up around your body. Chromoly gas tank bracket surrounds prop side if gas tank for safety. So the mounting bracket on the gas tank goes to the side of the unit. So even if the prop were to try to hit the gas tank, it has to go through that chromoly first. And so that adds quite a bit of protection. But because of the mounting plates, you can see the flat top engine does not flex up and down. If you do that to a fresh breeze, the whole engine is flexing up and down dramatically. So you have a whole lot less flex on the flat top. And of course, the tank is way out of the way, so you have a lot less issues. Okay, let's see. Plastic guessing slant won't injure legs if your leg happens to go back to hit it. Okay, so the gas tank bracket also goes back away from you. Some of them, that bracket mounts under the unit, right where your legs would be. So if your shoulder straps were a little loose and your leg did go back, it would actually hit a sharp metal object. But on the flat top, you have nothing but a flat plastic gas tank. So much, much safer. Four evenly spaced gas tank mounting holes for dual tank option. There's another cool thing about the flat top. With Fresh Breeze, all these other units, the flat top is basically the only unit on the market where you can run dual tanks. So at first I thought, well, why don't you just have one big gas tank so you have that much gas? And so I even had a custom gas tank made, full 5 gallons for the full legal limit. Well, then you realize that's one heavy son of a gun. So you don't want all that weight when most of your flights are gonna be under 3 hours. So the flat top Ninja can go upwards of 3 hours on one tank of gas. I actually set the world distance record on limited fuel on a flat top at 280 miles. It was a 7-hour and 13-minute flight. So you can fly a long dang way. Super Jordan and I have flown all over the place. Okay, so having the dual tank option. That way, you can have a single tank so you have the lightest possible weight for all of those flights when you wanna be under 3 hours or within a reasonable amount of time, but you can easily pop in that second tank for when you do want that extra range. But you can take it on and off very quick, very easily. So you got lightweight when you want it, but you got that extra range when you need it, so you have that full 5 gallon legal limit. Where a lot of the units have bigger tanks, which are heavier, but 98% of the time you don't fly over 3 hours, so you don't want all of that weight. That's yet another reason that the flat top is lighter. It's the lightest unit in its class, despite being about 100 times stronger than other units. Also, with the spacing on the tank, this is kind of another cool flat top only feature, but you can move the tank to the left or right, depending on the torque steer of the unit. So if you mounted an engine that had quite a bit of torque steer, which this one doesn't, but if you did, you could move the tank completely to the left or to the right to offset the torque and to balance that unit out. Where units with the gas tank above, they're doing very little and you can't move or change that center of gravity. So it's very nice being able to move the gas tank back and forth depending on where it's going. So flat top, dual tank option, works very, very nice. Modular gas tank mounting holes for left or right mounting of counter torque. So like I just said, you can move the gas tank back and forth depending on where you want to go. Unlike the Radney engine, it has a little bit more torque. So it actually works nice with that one because you can move the tank to the right, countering the left torque steer or whatever. But that makes it pretty simple. So you can move that around and get the best balance. Plus, of course, you have the lowest possible center of gravity. So if you do trip, you don't tend to go face first. And even if you do, you got the comfort bars. And that is page 8 of the 304 reasons why the flat top is obviously the only realistic unit. There's just no reason for over 100 people getting shredded in paramotors. Over 100 people just shredded in props alone, and they keep selling the exact same units with no updates. It's kind of a nightmare. Scout, Air Conception, Fly Products, Nirvana, Mini Plane, zero updates to prevent people getting chopped up in the props. They have no face plant protection, no crumple zone. So we will continue going on through the 304 reasons next time. Thank you.